going on, everyone? Welcome to another video. Now, what an exciting last couple of days it's been. And yes, I am back in the UK. I made it back through the border. What happened is I was emailed by Good Morning Britain and they said, we want to get you on the show with Piers Morgan. Piers Morgan was a judge for Britain's Got Talent and I think America's Got Talent. He's quite a well-known, controversial sort of TV host. He's known for attacking and coming hard at vegans. He's had a few vegans on the show.
So I think, who's killing those plants? Who's killing all those plants?
The other lady who is his co-host was Susanna Reid, and she's a vegetarian. And Anthony Worrell Thompson, who's a celebrity chef. I used to watch him on Ready Steady Cook, and I was about 20 years old. I used to watch him on TV, which is quite bizarre. Now, I was very nervous about this TV appearance because I wanted to keep it quite quiet. I didn't want to tell anyone I was in the UK just yet. A bit nervous until I seen this video.
It's not something I want to do. I'm just like Sam Cowell. I've got a lovely dog of my own and I wouldn't dream of eating her.
He wouldn't dream of eating dogs. Now this is really interesting. They did this in December 2017. Now let's just hear old Pierce's view on this. Very interesting.
What Anthony's getting at, and you know, I'm with the dogs. I don't think we should eat dogs, right? And nor does he, right? Mm. But he's pointing out that we do lay ourselves open, do we not, as a country, to a charge of utter hypocrisy.
Very interesting, Pierce. Continue.
Okay. Because we have decided dogs are not to be eaten, right? Because it's not our culture to do that.
But this is more
than that,
we're quite
happy to eat many other animals, which, by the way, we often farm in appalling conditions. Yeah.
Interesting. It seems like he's getting into the sort of speciesism area, like we are hypocrites in this country if we point our finger overseas to China where they eat dogs. There is no moral difference. Let's continue.
Can't we all agree?
Can't
we all agree that ill treatment of animals, if they're reared for farming, is terrible, whatever the animal?
Yeah. Whoa, ill treatment. Now, what constitutes ill treatment? This is really interesting.
Really, are we in a great position to just select which animals are sacred for us culturally? What's the difference between eating a pig and eating a dog?
What's the difference between eating a pig and eating a dog?
And I'm not sure what the answer is to that.
Well, I know the answer to that, mate. I know the answer to that.
Do you think? I mean, I don't. Of course, I don't encourage eating dogs.
Now, when I was watching this, we were jumping up and down. We were going, oh my God, they get it.
You are the only person in this room has the right to say what you're saying because you're vegan. And if you've got cultural issues and moral issues about the dogs, then go vegan.
They get it. This is 6 months ago. What ended up happening, we, in the morning, got ready, went to the ITV studios. I was quite nervous, but I had a bit of confidence knowing that they already got it. I uploaded this whole debate to YouTube, but they took it down for copyright. So now I've resorted to just making a response video, but if you want to see the full debate, it's down in the description box below. So let's get into what was said.
Well, one vegan activist wants to take things a lot further. He says that milk is murder.
That's because it is, Piers.
Lots of people, vegetarians, for instance, who...
You're a vegetarian, aren't you?
Who will happily consume dairy products and not think that they're doing anything wrong.
Well, that's true. They're disconnected from the process. I mean, 50% of the cow flesh in this country comes from spent dairy cows.
I made a point of calling it cow flesh and not beef. Instead of using a euphemism, I'd prefer to use what it actually is.
So all of the animals in the dairy industry will end up at a slaughterhouse. So they'll be killed against their will.
So a sort of efficient use of those animals then?
An efficient use, but not a moral use?
It doesn't make it moral whether it's an efficient use of an animal. If we were talking about dogs in those slaughterhouses, we'd never say that that's moral.
The reason I went straight to dogs is because of the interview I watched prior, so I wanted to bring the dogs into it because they understood that. Now let's see what Anthony Worrell Thompson comes in with me on.
Jerry, this is the food chain.
This is the food chain. Haven't heard that one before.
You know, the spider eats the fly, the cat eats the mouse. You know, a tiger would eat us if we got in its way. That is what's been going on for 8,000 years. We've been drinking milk.
So he's appealing to tradition. He's appealing to nature. He's saying because a tiger would kill and eat us, that's okay for us to kill and eat innocent animals that wouldn't attack us. Logical fallacies galore.
In the environment, animals eat out of necessity. They eat each other out of necessity. We have alternatives now. 30 different plant-based milks in the supermarket.
And very expensive they are too.
And very expensive for a carton of soy milk. You're looking at a pound or a pound and a half. I mean, $2. Not expensive at all.
You know, we need to give people...
$2 for soy milk.
It's still quite a lot of money compared to...
It's still quite a lot of money. I mean, come on. Now, we all know that dairy products are subsidised from the government as well, but let's just look at the water use. For 1 litre of dairy milk, we're looking at 1,000 litres of water, so it costs more than just money.
And have you tried drinking tea with soy milk?
I mean, I guarantee he hasn't tried tea with soy milk.
Delicious. Have you ever
terrible.
Tried? Have you ever tried almond milk, rice milk, coconut
yeah.
milk?
Yeah. None of it was tea.
Why are we?
And here he is claiming that he's tasted all of the plant milks. I doubt it.
Why are we still breastfeeding from a cow?
Why are we still breastfeeding from a cow? Let's see how he answers.
As full-grown adults, why are we still breastfeeding? We stopped breastfeeding as a toddler.
But plenty of you've...
True?
No answer. Interesting, Pierce. Couldn't answer that one, could you?
Well, there's rice milk. There's plenty of other different milks, not just nut milks.
None of those contain the same nutrients that dairy
milk. Sure.
Now, she's claiming that none of these plant milks contain the same nutrients that dairy milk contains. Now, we're forgetting some things that dairy does contain. Saturated fat, cholesterol, IGF-1, hormones, pus, blood. What about all those things?
Where does calcium come from? Plants, originally. How does the cow get the calcium in their body? Plants. We can get calcium from plants.
Yeah.
Imagine that. We can get calcium from plants.
Yeah,
what have you got against plants?
Here we go.
Plants are living things.
Plants are living things. I didn't think he was going to go there, but he went there.
They're not sentient. They don't have a central
nervous
system.
How do I know what plants feel? Now, we're talking to... you know, Pierce Morgan here on national television.
Do you think stabbing a puppy dog in the throat is the same as cutting up a carrot?
How do you know what plants feel?
How do I know a carrot doesn't feel pain when you stab a knife into it? And how do I know a puppy dog does? I mean, this is the level of intelligence we're talking about here.
They're living, but they're not sentient.
You don't mind slaughtering living plants?
Terrible argument. I think Anthony's on my side here.
Yes,
because they don't feel pain.
That argument's really
weak. If you're
weak.
In hospital and you're paralysed, what do they call you? A vegetable.
You think my argument's weak?
I think your argument is weak.
Even Anthony thought your argument was weak. Let's just say plants on some planet did feel pain. Animals are consuming 16 times more plants to make 1 kilo of their flesh. So we're killing less plants by just eating the plants ourselves. Plants are not sentient. They don't feel pain.
A lot of people might be tempted to take up a more vegan-based diet.
Yeah.
But they hate this kind of vegan terrorism that's going on.
Vegans are terrorists. More people would take up this plant-based way of eating. More people would stop abusing and terrorizing animals if it wasn't for vegan terrorists. Imagine that logic, calling those who are trying to stop the terrorism of animals terrorists.
It's about the animals.
It's not about the vegans or the vegan terrorists. It's about the animals.
Are you against animal cruelty?
Are you against animal cruelty? Now, I already knew he was because of his prior interview.
I'm against animal cruelty.
Of course. It's not cruel to bolt
I'm against human cruelty.
Me too.
We all are. We are all against human cruelty. You can't be against animal cruelty and human cruelty as well? Of course you can.
I don't kill humans either, but to kill animals for a product we don't need is cruel.
He didn't have an answer for that. Interesting how he didn't have many answers.
You have every right to be a vegan, as I have every right to be a meat eater. And you can do that, but please don't thrust the message down everyone's throat that we all have to change to veganism.
The only beings
totally
who are being
wrong.
Thrusted are the animals who are being forced into slaughterhouses for an unnecessary reason. You just said that you're against animal cruelty, so this is your belief.
Whoa. The only beings who are being forced are the animals who are being forced into slaughterhouses. And the thing is about forcing opinions. I mean, if people are out there abusing dogs or abusing children and there's a bunch of activists who are speaking up against it, no one's going to say you're forcing your opinion. People are going to say thank you for sticking up for these children who are being abused and these dogs who are being abused. But as soon as it's cows, chickens or pigs, everyone's like, oh, stop forcing your opinions. I mean, it's just completely ridiculous.
You shouldn't be exploiting animals, period.
Right, so your issue is not really about milk, is it? Your issue is just anything to do with animals. Mm. You've got a problem with it.
Anything to do with animal exploitation, yes.
Right? Using animals and viewing them as products is a moral issue.
Well, what is wrong with a cow being milked for milk?
What isn't wrong with it? Infant animals being taken away from their mother. Bobby calves are all bolt gunned in their head sometimes on their first day of life. Sexual abuse, exploitation, I mean... all of them go to the slaughterhouse. What isn't wrong with milk?
It's unnecessary.
Why do you need breast milk?
Joey, it's not.
You need breast milk from a cow? You're not a baby cow, bro.
It is not unnecessary.
I'm not a baby cow,
you're not a baby cow.
Bro.
You're a human being.
Guys, it's not unnecessary.
I am certainly not a baby cow, bro.
It's not unnecessary.
If you don't want to be called a baby cow, you better stop acting like a baby cow and get off the titty juice, mate.
Got millions and millions of things, what are you going to do with them?
There's millions and millions of animals. What are we going to do with them if we stop drinking their breast milk?
What is your practical stance?
I'll give you an answer to that. As more and more of us go plant-based and vegan, gradually we'll stop forcibly breeding all these animals into existence and the numbers will slowly decline.
And the world's not going to go vegan overnight.
Are you a man of peace? Is what this really boils down to?
What it really boils down to, Joey, is are you, personally, a man of peace?
Am I a man of peace? Yes, I am.
I had a thought. He's going to bring up my past. My past has been open for years on the internet. I'm the one who's, you know, let people know about my past. It's been part of me changing my ways. Now, are you a man of peace? Let's see what he whips out.
You don't believe in harming other human beings?
No, I don't believe in harming other human beings anymore. Of course I don't.
In September 2011, you were arrested when police found a loaded, sawn-off pump-action
rifle. Oh, a character attack.
As if he whips that out in a debate about dairy. I mean, I got on to this show to talk about whether or not milk is murder. Now, if you Google up Joey Carbstrong, the first article's going to come up. You know, newspapers have already gone into my criminal history. I've been quite open about why I went to prison. Carrying a loaded firearm. Now, obviously I don't harm humans anymore, but I was in gangs, gang violence. I mean, I'm defending myself as well. Back then, drinking alcohol, consuming all types of drugs. I've been very open about that. To whip that out in a debate as an argument for drinking dairy, what's that? It's a logical fallacy, isn't it? He's trying to attack me instead of attacking the message, trying to attack my character. It's irrelevant to whether or not dairy is cruel.
No, a
has
fact.
This got anything to do with the topic at hand?
Well, you were, okay.
It's a character attack it's called a on
fact.
My past.
It's called a fact.
Everyone has a past, old Pierce, don't they? Everyone up on that panel has a past. Even Anthony, you do.
Okay.
Were you found with a pump action rifle down your trousers?
Would this be relevant if I was speaking up against dog abuse or child abuse?
I'm asking you a question.
Would my past be relevant if I was speaking up against child abuse or dog abuse? That's a good, very interesting question. Or would people just be like, great, congratulations, thanks for turning your life around and helping out these children and these, you know, these dogs who are being abused.
This is no way to have a debate on
here,
dairy.
Please, everyone makes mistakes.
Wait a minute.
This is a character.
I'm simply asking a question.
Okay.
Got quite heated here.
Was your intention with the bullets and the rifle and the flick knife to cause harm to human beings?
Okay, let me answer that.
What has this got to do with dairy to start with? I mean, this is a distraction, diversion, real diversion. But I answer him.
I used to consume animal products 3 times a day as well. So I was harming animals and humans, okay? But I changed my life around and now I'm vegan. Now, just because I did something wrong in the past doesn't mean I can't do something right now. How does that justify your abuse of dairy cows so you can have milk in your coffee?
Exactly. It doesn't justify his abuse of dairy cows currently. Now, anyone can do something wrong in the past and turn their life around.
You've had to flee here, bud. Why don't you tell folks?
Here.
Yeah, you fled here. Why don't you go back and face the charges for the hacking scandal?
Answer this question. How many
Why'd you get fired from the Daily Mirror for putting out fake stories?
Ooh. Everyone's got a past, Pierce.
Seems to me you were a pretty violent guy.
I used to be.
Yeah. And a pretty voracious
And you can't turn your life around and do something good for
exactly.
animals?
Exactly. Everyone is entitled. Let him go.
I want to see.
Seems like Anthony was very defensive of me there. Leave him alone. I mean, I've got a thick skin. Anthony obviously doesn't really know me, but I thought it was really sweet of him to come behind me and go, leave him alone. This is a personal attack. It's got nothing to do with the debate on dairy. I mean,
I realise veganism, it's not my thing, but I realise it's a growing thing.
It is.
It's not your thing?
You just said you're against animal cruelty and it's not your thing. So what? Animal cruelty is your thing? Abusing animals is your thing? Slaughterhouses are your thing?
My problem is this kind of vegan terrorism that goes on.
The only terrorism that is happening is the animals who are being terrorised in abattoirs and farms for milk in your tea piss.
He's against animal cruelty. So
everyone that
thing.
Drinks milk, according to you, is a murderer.
That is a straw man fallacy. I never said everyone who drinks milk is a murderer. I'm saying milk products are murder. They cause murder. Now, does that mean everyone's conscious of it? Are they conscious murderers? No.
No, not consciously. They don't know. But now you know what happens to animals in slaughterhouses so you can have milk in your coffee. And what are you going to do about it?
Now you know, Pierce. Now you know. And you are conscious of it. And what are you going to do to change that?
A lot of cows that get milked don't go to slaughterhouses.
Not all cows that get milked go to slaughterhouses. Pierce Morgan, 2018. It seems like you did more research on me than you did on the dairy industry.
You don't know nothing about the industry, my friend.
I don't
know
nothing about the industry.
They all get slaughtered.
Joey, the trouble is, I think even if Piers does know what happens, that for lots of people, that's not a problem.
Well, you know what? There's billions of other people who would see what happens to dairy cows in slaughterhouses, would see their, you know, their infants being taken away from them and killed, who would have a problem with that. So luckily, not all of us are like Pierce.
I've seen the animals were being abused and chopped up on my plate, and I felt hypocrisy in my heart. What we have to do is
a lot of people don't see. I personally don't eat meat, but a lot of people don't see it as hypocrisy.
Why would those people on that panel so vehemently defend dogs but be happy for cows to go to the slaughterhouse for their dairy? I mean, Pierce said it himself.
We do lay ourselves open, do we not, as a country, to a charge of utter hypocrisy.
The country is left open to a charge of hypocrisy.
I love vegan people who want, because they are the only pure people. Vegetarians aren't pure.
He is paying a bit of lip service to veganism. Yeah, I love vegans. I love your views and I love that you have those views. Don't force them on me though. But he does get it. I felt like Anthony was one of the most honest people on that panel. He really was.
If you want to get rid of animal cruelty, you go vegan. And that is right.
You do too though, don't you?
But I want to get, I will progress. I'm eating more plant-based diet, but I still like my meat.
You're a chef, you know how to make things out
of
plants.
Of course I do.
Are slaughterhouses necessary?
All right.
Yes, at the moment they are.
A necessity. Do you need it fundamentally for your survival or your health? Do we need slaughterhouses? Of course we don't.
Do you renounce all violence against, for instance, the farming industry or butcher shops?
I've never advocated for violence to spread a peaceful message.
There was a time early in my activism where I was quite extreme in the things I've said, and I've admitted those things and publicly renounced them.
So
anything I've said in the past, I've changed my advocacy. When I first went vegan, I was quite angry about what was happening to animals, and rightly so. If they were dogs, you could...
Have you ever seen the comment section when there's some dog cruelty and someone's abusing a dog, and the comment section full of people who aren't vegan gone, that person who's abusing the dog deserves exactly what he's doing to that dog to happen to him. I hope he gets karma, I hope he dies, blah, 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 blah. You read it. People can turn really ugly when they see someone harming an innocent animal, and that, I admit, that's how I used to react. A normal emotional response to seeing someone abusing cows or shooting animals.
Alongside the video entitled Ethical Hunters Deserve a Bullet in the Head, you wrote, I hope one of these bleeps accidentally shoot one of their own family members in the face.
Now, this is all online for everyone to see. The media have taken, you know, things I said 2 years ago when I was quite an aggressive activist, and they're using it. And now Pierce is using it in a debate, you know, to do with dairy, which is completely like, it's a side issue. What I used to say bears no weight on how cruel the dairy industry is now and whether we should be supporting the dairy industry. I mean,
keyword,
that was 2 years ago.
2016,
2 years
when
ago.
I first went vegan and I seen people hunting innocent animals. If they were hunting dogs, have you ever seen dog cruelty videos in
but
the comment
section?
Exactly. The comment section, you check, all non-vegans. Oh, this guy deserves exactly. Oh, I can't believe he harmed that poor dog. Oh, if I got my hands on him.
Another video in 2016. It's only 2 years ago. Another video in 2016. Australian dairy farmers should do the cows a favour. Kill yourselves.
Come on, mate. You're reaching at the bottom of the barrel. The media have already taken all of that and ran with it. We've already seen all the articles. What else have you got?
Hey, do I stand by that statement? I've publicly renounced those.
Mate, that was 2 years ago. All right, we've got to leave it there.
That's all you got, mate. That is your argument for consuming dairy. Whether or not milk is murder. Something I said. What has that got to do with anything? Complete diversion tactic, and that's the only ammunition he had. So that was the debate. I mean, it turned out quite well. Afterwards, I had a chat with some of the studio staff and really loved it. It was a lively debate.
You get those valid points across because it does make you think, and it will make people think. Baby cows.
But then that's good because people need to know that. They're not baby cows.
Yeah.
You know, I felt like it went reasonably well.
The fact is, I'm a controversial figure in the movement. I have this controversial past, and they want to get me on the show. They want controversy. They want a lively debate, and they get one. They're going to get one. And yeah, my past isn't perfect. The media, they've been latching onto it. And even this story has already made 6 or 7 articles across the UK. So what a way to make a comeback to the UK. I mean, so I'll leave it there. Pierce, you know, why don't you get some proper arguments? Stay on topic with the debate. You know, you don't have any argument against veganism. Just admit it. So thank you everyone for all your support. Damn, it feels good to be back here in the UK.
Publicly renounced. I hope not.
Mate, that was 2 years ago. All right, we've got to leave it there. We've got to leave it there.
After attacks.
Thank you very much indeed. ITV has made...
Making some changes. Let's change the way we eat. Let's change the way we live. And let's change the way we treat each other. You see, the old way wasn't working, so it's on us to do what we gotta do to survive. And still I see no changes.